Fox, Carolina. Hope you guys are having a good night. If you are stuck in traffic, I hope that your night improves, because all of these cars here behind me, they're moving at a glacier pace, unfortunately. Glacial pace, I should say. And let me turn around so you can see what's going on here. That tanker right there caught on fire earlier today around 5:30. It crossed over the guardrail is what we were hearing from a few people around the area, and it caught on fire. Now, there was one person that was taken to the hospital. We're not sure which car they came out of at that point, but you can see just how active this scene is still here, you know, even past 10 o'clock right now. And look at this. It's hard to see on the phone, I know, so I apologize, but that is just a line of traffic. It goes down for miles. I was in it for about an hour and a half myself. It is no cakewalk. But, you know, if you're in that mess right now, be patient. These troopers, you know, firefighters, the hazmat team, they're working really hard to get, you know, cleanup crews out here to try and get this mess cleaned up right now. You can see just right here, they have some lights on it now, thankfully, so you can get a better look. But that is that tanker that had flames just engulfed around it because of that crash. DHEC, the hazmat team, they're all working to try and figure out what happened and how it caught on fire. That's still being developed right now, but really what people care about is how it's, of course, blocking the interstate from where they need to go, right around Anderson. This is around exit 24, and there is just, you know, tons of first responders out here. Huge thank you to them to try and clean up this mess. I think they're waiting for a cleanup crew also to come out to help them with this. As far as what's inside, I know some of you were asking, what is this tanker carrying? 9,000 pounds of ammonium nitrate. That is a highly, highly explosive fertilizer, which is why emergency crews are taking this so seriously. We're going to have updates, of course, on our website. Stick with us. We are out here pretty much the entire night to try and get this mess cleaned up, keep you guys in the loop as far as when it is clear. But right now, it's a waiting game. You can see all those workers out there trying to clean up the mess. We talked to a few people around the area. If they lived about a mile away or so, they had to be evacuated because of just how dangerous the chemical inside of that tanker really is. Again, I'll give you a look over here. Traffic for miles. So if you can avoid it, try, if you're coming from, you know, the Greenville area into Anderson County, try and take those back roads. There are detours set in place. We have all that information on our website at foxcarolina.com. Let me get you closer to here. A headache as well. All of the back roads, they're pretty much clogged up right now as well. So if you can, please be patient. This is causing obviously a lot of chaos on the highway, but also around the highway as well. You know, one crash just taking up the entire afternoon and evening. Of course, we're hoping and praying that everyone involved is okay, but you can see that tanker, it's facing northbound in a southbound lane. Now, the northbound lanes, they are reopened, you know, for the most part, but these southbound lanes here, that's where the trouble is. So if you can avoid this area, that's your biggest set of concerns right now. We will be getting updates periodically throughout the evening. 10:30 and 11 o'clock is when we'll have hopefully some new information. But like I said, keep in touch with us with our Facebook as well as our Fox Carolina News app. As soon as we know something, we send it directly to that app. So when we know, you will know. But again, be patient. If you're stuck in this mess right here, I know I was once one of those cars sitting behind the wheel. Be patient. Take a few deep breaths. I know road rage can be, you know, an option right then and there, but just take a few deep breaths and try and understand that these guys are working really hard out here to clean up the mess. Again, exit 24 is where we're standing right now to do some live shots throughout the evening to bring you coverage both on air and online at foxcarolina.com.